reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. We know that all things work for good for those who love God, who are called according to his purpose. For those he foreknew, he also predestined to be conformed to the image of his Son, so that he might be the firstborn among many brothers. And those he predestined, he also called. And those he called, he also justified. And those he justified, he also glorified. What then shall we say to this? If God is for us, who can be against us? He who did not spare his own Son, but handed him over for us all, how will he not also give us everything else along with him? Who will bring a charge against God's chosen ones? It is God who acquits us. Who will condemn? It is Christ Jesus who died, rather, was raised, who also is at the right hand of God, who indeed intercedes for us. What will separate us from the love of Christ? Will anguish or distress, or persecution or famine or nakedness, or peril or the sword? As it is written, for your sake we are being slain all the day. We are looked upon as sheep to be slaughtered. No, in all these things we conquer overwhelmingly through him who loved us. For I am convinced that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor present things or future things, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus, our Lord.
resurrection of Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That by contemplating the Lord and his mysteries, we may pour out our lives in love for him. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That seeking the Lord will lead us to encounter him with joy as he calls out our name with love. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That after accompanying the Lord on the way of life, all the faithful departed may live with him in paradise. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Holy Spirit renew in us the vows we have professed and strengthen our service and charity to one another. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Trust in